Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm gonna make a video about the shooting that I did with my gun for the first time last week. I was able to take it to the range and try out the Beretta 92X performance for the first time. My main aim over there was to be able to set up my sights so that I can shoot at 25 meters accurately. I typically have my sights always at the border of the white and the black part of the shooting paper or the target. Let me show you how that looks like. So that's typically the shooting target that I use, and I have the sides, the front sides lined right here at the edge so that I get my aim over here. Now this is the second target that I use, and you can see that I'm shooting top right. Most of the time the shots appear to be drifting out a bit. It's a very beautiful diagonal that I've made over here. Some of my friends say that it looks like art. I don't buy it, but obviously there's a long way for me to go where I can develop some trigger discipline. Sorry about that. I meant a proper trigger technique where I'm not, like, pulling exactly behind and not drifting and applying pressure in all possible directions on the trigger. Nevertheless, it's pretty good as comparison to what I had in the beginning, where all my shots were typically landing right here, like way below. The sights were not properly set. I think this, if I'm able to like have a better trigger technique, I can bring this grouping right close to towards the center and like still get a bunch of points. I mean, this is a precision target. I'm planning to go for IPSC. This is not the target that I'll be using. Nevertheless, it was the one I chose to do the sight setting of my Beretta 92X. I really wanted to show today to you how do you clean the gun. I did make a time-lapse video when I came back in the evening from the range and cleaned up the gun. However, I'm recording my phone and the video on my iPhone, and it wasn't really, I'd say the frequency was too low and the video ended up being very, very fast, and it's unintelligible. You cannot see or understand what's going on. My gun is now clean, it's oiled up, and it's all pretty good for go in rest for until I go to the next and go to the range the next time. But nevertheless, let me just show you what I typically do to clean up my gun when I'm coming back from the range. Field stripping of the gun is the most important part, first of all. So it's very pretty straightforward how you field strip the gun on the 92X Performance. You have the slide release button over here. You click that and pull the latch below as so, and your slide will just pop off in the front. From here on, simply slide off, remove it from the frame, and there you go. It's now separated from the body. I'm just gonna flip it and put it on the other direction so it has a better support and I don't get my pad all oiled up over here. All right, it's just like kind of oiled it up pretty much. Very good on the slides. You take off your recoil spring from here, take off the barrel, and basically just clean it off as well as you can, as good as you can. Over here, it's like a lot of soot accumulating from the inner part of the slide, which you need to also get rid of and clean. I typically also like to use oil all over the slide over here for me, and I also like to the recoil spring guide. I like to oil it up very well. It's one of the parts which is under high stress, and it moves quite often and quite fast when you are like shooting at the rate you do at IPSC shooting. It's quite essential that it's like well oiled up. You didn't need to drown it, but a thin consistent film of oil over the recoil spring guide rod and the recoil spring is pretty I'd say it's essential. Apart from that, all the moving mechanisms of the barrel need to be oiled up also quite well. While you do that, make sure that you do not put oil inside your striker pin, inside your firing pin here. Be sure don't oil it up too much. It's also said and mentioned on the manual there not to do that. Am I going to okay, I do not intend to field strip it right now. It's like all clean stuff and I really do not intend to take it apart at this point. But I'll show you what tools I use and what order I use them, what products I've used in order to clean the gun and to make it as good as new. It almost looks at the way the time I unpacked it, and absolutely no soot over here apart from a little bit of oil that is there for lubrication, that for the purpose. Obviously, I've also oiled up my, there's a very thin film of oil on the barrel. I usually keep it like this. It's recommended also by the Beretta manual to do that, and so that you have good protection against moisture. Yeah. With the slide on the side, I'll show you how I did this stuff for my frame. It's the same thing for the frame on the rails of the slide rails. I put some oil. I put oil also onto the rails where the slide is basically catching to the frame and sliding all over it. Also a little bit onto the hammer mechanisms, all the while making sure that you're not putting excessive oil in the barrel region, or you're not putting oil so that the ammunition will catch, especially over here where your round is guided right inside the barrel at this point from the magazine. Exactly. I'm just gonna release the magazine out of it. Let me get and put it on the side over here. Exactly. And a very thin film of oil right inside in the magwell as well, just so that the mag also slides pretty straightforward and pretty nicely when you go to the range for the next time. That's pretty much it that I do with it. I also use certain brushes to clean up the soot that accumulates here from constant shooting. I intend to keep this gun for a very long time, and I also love it, so I want it to be always gleaming and shiny all the time. Although it's possible if you use it for a long time, you never really will keep it as good looking as you did in the first day. But yeah, when you're in love with a firearm, you want to do it. All right, let me put the gun back again, and I'll show you the products that I have used to clean the gun. The gun goes back very easily. You just slide on the rail over here and just push it back. Once it latches in well, just bring it back all the way and engage the slide catch, and then it stops over here, and just remove the turn the gas pedal top back again, and the slide is locked. One common thing that I've seen a lot of newbie beginner shooters along with me in my batch is that they always at this point just cool and pull the slide release down, and the slide goes ramming onto the barrel, an empty chamber. It's not good for your firing pin. It's not good for your extractor pin, so just don't do that. It's not worth it. Always with an empty chamber, just push the slide a bit back and ease it way all the way through. Obviously, you need to release tension on the hammer, just pull on it, slightly depress the trigger, and there you go. It's all now nicely put back together, and it's all ready to go. All right, let me show you what all things I used for cleaning my gun. I have a set of cleaning equipment that I use. The most important thing is you need a oil rag. I'd recommend that. I just have like a rag which you can use in order to put a very thin film of oil all over your firearm. What I'm using for oil is the Gunex Ballistol. This is for everything, for lubrication to cleaning and stuff, so it's pretty nice. Just shake it off a bit, put it a bit, very small piece of it and just wipe over your firearm, and it leaves a very thin film of oil all over the firearm, so especially towards the points where you are like constantly touching, this is the trigger, the grips, and the dovetail for it, etc. Once you have that, you have like a very thin film. Don't like overdo it, just wipe off excess, because this unnecessarily attracts a lot of dirt and dust, which can obstruct the proper functioning of the firearm. Not obviously from the outside, it's fine. I like to have it a bit shiny and looking very gleamy. Oh my god. So I tend to overdo it a little bit. Don't have to. Exactly. So that's the oiling part of it. There are certain things that I use for cleaning the... Here it is again. The Ballistol Gunex. I just have a 200 milliliter spray. It will last you for a long time. I use it for my Beretta shotgun as well. Basically, all other firearms you can use it. It's universal. You also put a small film on your magazine. It's also a good idea because it keeps sliding in and out. So, for optimal experience, let's say, you could also put a very thin film of oil on your magazine, exactly the way I did for the firearm. A very thin film, you don't really have to dip your magazine in oil. I've seen this couple of times. You just don't really need that much oil on the firearm. It's mostly for on the surface treatment. It's to maintain the surface treatment or to prevent rusting and prevent damage from moisture. Right, let's get into the other part. Let me show you the box that I'm using for cleaning my firearms. Let me get the gun out of the... So that's my beautiful box of cleaning material. I really love it. It has a really nice diagram of parts that you will use with a nice index at the bottom. It supports a bunch of calibers over here. It's pretty universal and it's a good investment. I think I paid $30 for it on Amazon, and it's a good addition, with some phosphor bronze brushes over here, with some cleaning mops in different calibers, some rods for you to also drive through your, or just rod attachments that you can use in order to go through different barrel ends, etc. Typically use the one that I use for 9mm 357 Magnum is this phosphor bronze brush. You typically add it with a short adapter like so here. You put this together so, and select one of these bars that are there, or rods that help you drive this down the barrel. The important thing to remember at this point is never to clean your gun from the muzzle end. Don't ever put this brush through the muzzle end. You will just damage the muzzle. It's not recommended. It's always a better idea to put this brush and clean your gun only in one direction. And you put this in from the chamber side. You need to open the slide and just put this through your... or the best idea is just to remove the slide, take the barrel out, and just put it from the chamber side and not from the other side. So that's a brush. You spray some oil in inside your barrel from the chamber side. Put this thing inside and give it good scrubs, going only one way. Unscrewing the brush again, removing the rod again, and putting the brush again and cleaning it again, right? A couple of times, it loosens up all the burnt carbon that is there inside your barrel, or if there are any lead residue that is left in, if you're firing partially or not a full metal jacket rounds or hollow points, etc. So just remove all that burnt residue from your barrel with this. And then as next is Cleaning up the barrel, you typically use a mop, and there's one again that fits your caliber. Here's 357 Magnum and 9mm. You put it in the attachment likewise, just as you did for the cleaning brush. And again, at this point, spray some gun oil on top of it, like soak it a bit, and then just push it through a couple of times so that you have oiled the barrel from within very well, and it's now set for protected against moisture. One thing you might want to do before coming to this step is taking some mops and pushing it down the barrel and cleaning it up until it becomes, it's not leaving any black residue on top of it. Well, that's pretty much it that you gotta do with cleaning up the barrel. Some other accessories that I use for cleaning the guns include some brushes, an old toothbrush, I'd say, is also quite handy. A brush like this I typically use to get to places where there is, on specifically these railings where I can't get in. As I said, like, I'm very picky and I want it to look always I want the gun to look very pretty, and I'm like going a step beyond. You don't really need this stuff, it's just for my eye candy. Never hurts, still gets you around when you open up the slide at the points where you don't really get with a mop or a brush, or you don't have a soft enough brush that does not damage the finishing on your gun. I also use an old toothbrush. It's for the places and regions where the softer brush would not do, where you need to scratch it off and remove all the carbon from there, specifically onto the breech face. Or also, there are certain catchy areas under the slide. That's where I use this small brush to clean it. Well, that's pretty much it about how I clean the firearm, and once it's done, it goes well back inside the gun safe. All right, that was a very short overview how I clean it. There are different ways. You might have a different opinion how you clean your gun. You may be less picky than me, you may be more picky than me, but that's how it works. It's pretty straightforward, it's basic, it's not no rocket science. Good TLC for your gun, and yeah, that makes me happy. Yeah, thank you for your time. I wish you a great day ahead.